Rishi Sunak and Liz Truss.
Just as we learnt her name but not necessarily how to spell it, the shower of shit gets reduced to two candidates as Penny Mordaunt goes out of the race. The world reacts to the news by doing their best Penny Mordaunt diving impressions. Now a new leader will be chosen, and there'll be harmony for a few weeks before suspicion, paranoia and recriminations creep in. Shortly afterwards, the Conservative Party will implode, and at general election they will be defeated and sit in opposition for over a decade. But enough about these jokers, let's enjoy one last hurrah for Boris as we present the highlights of his last ever Prime Minister's Questions.
I'll do the talking. You leave it to me. I've been here before.
Every time they've left office, it's with unemployment higher, they're economically illiterate, Mr. Speaker, and they would wreck the economy.
Yeah. On behalf of 17.4 million people who voted Brexit, may I thank him for restoring people's belief in democracy. And most of all, on behalf of the people of Ukraine, may I thank him for holding high the torch of freedom. For true grit and determination, keep going and thank you.
Mr. Speaker, I want to use the last few seconds, Mr. Speaker, to give some words of advice to my successor, whoever he or she may be. Number one, stay close to the Americans, stick up for the Ukrainians, stick up for freedom and democracy everywhere. Remember, above all, it's not Twitter that counts. The last few years have been the greatest privilege of my life, and it's true that I helped to get the biggest Tory majority for 40 years. I've helped to get this country through a pandemic and help save another country from barbarism. And frankly, that's enough to be going on with. Mission largely accomplished. For now, I want to thank you, Mr. Speaker. I want to thank all the wonderful staff of the House of Commons. I want to thank all my friends and colleagues. I want to thank my rival friend opposite, Mr. Speaker. I want to thank everybody here, and hasta la vista, baby. Thank you.
My country stands up to bullies.
But it gets quite serious if the online manipulation can make you Prime Minister.
And I am intensely proud of what this government has done.